teacher decided to use the N-word and a bunch of other racial slurs, derogatory comments in an assignment. Let's put up the picture of the school first. What I'm about to tell you is unbelievable, but it did happen. I'm talking about in Texas, all right? Killeen, Texas, at Rancier Middle School. One of its teachers has now parted ways after the educator assigned middle schoolers worksheets loaded with racist slurs and offensive language. There are multiple forms of assignments that used these words. Let's put it up. Who in the hell would create a curriculum like this? There was a trigger word search. Let me say that again, a trigger word search. The words included the N-word, the B-word, the R-word, and the word dumbass, along with crackhead, stupid, fat, ugly. That was the actual assignment handed out by a middle school teacher. Then they had this assignment. This was the match the term with the definition, using the N-word, the R-word, and the B-word. Okay? And then there was fill in the blank, using the N-word, the R-word, and the B-word. And then this, okay? In case that wasn't offensive enough, they have a scramble version of it. Yeah, scramble. The B word, the N word, everything else. How about this one? A color by work. Okay. A use of each trigger word in a sentence using the N word, R word, and B word. You got to use it in a sentence, children. This assignment literally says, use each word in a sentence. You really got to pause on this for a moment. So while one governor in one state, he's threatening to lock up teachers for a felony if they read Winnie the Pooh unapproved in the school, there's another teacher in another state who's doing this. Is she going to be threatened with arrest? Hell no, of course not. No, not at all. Texas, they got their priorities together. You can say N-word all day, hand out lessons. You do realize this whole thing was about the N-word. Everything else was offensive, yes, but that was the real intent here. That's my opinion. Tiana Maya, a spokesperson for the district, told 25 News that she's unsure if the teacher was fired or resigned. Now, isn't that something? I would have made it crystal clear that her ass was fired if I was the principal. So it's unclear, but both parties have separated. Among Rancier's population of 785 students, 90% identify as minority, with the majority of students classified as Black and Hispanic. That's according to data from the Texas Department of Education. The former teacher in question has not yet been identified. We are still trying to identify this particular educator so that we can let people know, do not hire this individual. We are unaware if they have done the right thing, which is to put her on a list that says she can no longer work. I don't think they did the right thing personally, because decertification would be the only right thing to do at this point. All right, Sharon, thoughts here?
I gotta tell you, well, can I start with the spokesperson, Dr. Richey? Because Tiana can't be the spokesperson anymore, okay? You're ineffective in the spokesperson role. This teacher caught the ignorant train to school, and you're right, decertification should not teach anyone anywhere. If you send your kids to this middle school teacher, they will feel worse about themselves and they'll get a whole lot dumber. I don't understand, which everything's turned upside down, Dr. Richey.
Yep.
Okay, as you mentioned, Florida, Texas, this whole thing is a scam.
Yeah, it really is. But it goes to show that when states start saying, hey, let's loosen the standards for educators. Let's make sure people who have never gone to college, but they served in the military, can now teach history. Well, they're doing that to serve a particular agenda, all right? Okay, we'll bring you updates as it comes. I hope that they actually do release the information of the school teacher who does serve the public, or at least did at one point.